for you, let's unpack it a little bit, because the site of the poem is the page in the mind, and it's a poem is a made thing, and it's a kind of precinct. It can create a place where we can think about and feel and concentrate on something. I mean, poems on the underground, I think, I don't know, those of you who have been in cities where poems on the underground works, it's really wonderful to see a whole crowded tube carriage of people with all sorts of jostling other feelings of the day. And then there's a little poem, six lines, and you see them really concentrating on it. And it takes them out of themselves and yet into themselves. And I think that's what poetry can do, and give you a place where you can be both in yourself very deeply, but also see outside. So for me, yes, I've written these poems about migration. We're honoring John Berger in a lot of these things. And he has when I was writing, it took me 30 years, that book, and I was reading him, and he says, hope is born on the site of loss. And I think poetry is probably born on the site of loss as well, or it can be, of the many places poetry is born. And when I was doing those migration poems, I was thinking about migration across the board, so in the body, cells in the body, souls, migration of souls, jellyfish, birds, sea snakes, everything that commutes and migrates. And then, of course, it came to people. And finally, there were these poems of migration, of what's happening now. I don't know those of you who know the wonderful photographer Salgado, and again, John Berger, a huge, wonderful conversation with him. He was doing his book on migrations came out in 2005, I think, and the numbers have doubled since then. And they are so eloquent. And so I have done, I might read one tiny poem from it, which went viral after I did it in the Museum of Migration. And it's just very small. And I think this is what another thing that poetry can do, and how it can help us live. This is not my experience, whereas the cave was my experience. This is about having gone into a bit of detention centres and talked to people, my daughter having worked in an asylum place and so on. So this is an act of sympathy and imagination. This is what happens when you have spent 3 years in a detention centre, which I notice in the last few years have been changed their names to immigrant removal centres instead of detention centre. Purple Ink. She has waited 3 years for this, too ashamed to even half tell the young woman in spectacles tapping a purple biro on a desk exactly what the soldiers did to her, each versatile in his turn. She gets wrong, date your mother was born, and sees a stamp the colour of desert night descend on her fire. So that came out of the fact that ever since 9/11 there's been a new stamp, LOC, lack of credibility. These traumatized refugees turn up at the border and they're interviewed. 3 years later, when they finally get their thing, they might get a detail from that interview different. And that was the grounds for refusal. And I, you know, so this is the poetry, as it were, of rage transmuted into sympathy. So that's another sort of poetry, I think, and another sort of place.